Welcome to my new video in the LINQ tutorial. Today I am going to introduce you the average function in LINQ. If you want to learn more about LINQ, please watch the LINQ playlist on my channel. There are many other videos about different functions in LINQ. And if you have any specific question, or if you want to learn about any function in LINQ, please write me a comment, and I will try to help you. If you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel to see the new videos. Let's go. Before I explain the average function in LINQ, let me first remind you how to calculate the average of different numbers. The average function is calculated as follows. You sum the numbers together, then divide them by the count of numbers. For example, we have the following two numbers. 1 and 2. We sum 1 and 2 together. That makes 3. The count of numbers in this example is 2. This means, we divide 3 by 2. That gives the number 1.5. That's the average of those two numbers. Let's take another example. We have the following three numbers. We do the same again. We sum the numbers and then divide by 3, because there are three numbers. Let's take another example. We have the following six numbers. We do the same again. This gives the number 3.5 as average. In this way, the average of numbers is calculated. That's all math so far, which has nothing to do with LINQ. I just wanted to do a little rep. Before I start, let's see what points I'm going to address in this video. First, I will show you how to calculate the average for an array. In the second part, I will show you how to calculate the average of a column in a data table. And in the last part, I will show you how to calculate the average of a column, but using additional criteria from other columns. Let's start with the first part. Average of numbers in an array. I have this integer array, which consists of 9 numbers. I want to calculate the average of these numbers. Let's see how the query looks like. We first set the array variable. Then the function as enumerable. At the end comes the average function. Let's set the query for this array. As mentioned, first we set the array variable. Then the other two functions. That's it. Very easy. Let's implement it in UiPath. First I will create the variables. The first one is the array variable. I will create an integer array. Here I will add the content of this array. It contains the numbers from 1 to 9. I will create another variable for the output. It should be of type double. Search for this type as follows. Now I will write the LINQ query in an assign activity. I will write the same query as I showed you before. First the array variable and then the other functions. I will add write line activity to print the output to the console. Let's run the code to see the result. As you can see, we have the number 5 as output. It's the average of the numbers in this array. Now let's move to the next point. In this part of video I will show you how to get the average of all rows of column in a data table. I have this table. It consists of 3 columns. I want to calculate the average of the third column, price. Let's first see how the query looks like. We first set the data table variable. Then the function as enumerable. After that the function average. Then I will open brackets. In these brackets I first set a function. For this function I set a variable, for example x. After that I set the function, cdec. This function is to convert the content of the column into decimal variable. We can also use other types, like double or integer. Then I will use the variable x to get the content of the column. So here I can set the column name, for which I want to calculate the average. Instead of the column name we can use the column index. In this example, the column index for the column price is 2. After that we set the function to string, to get the content of the column as string. At the end we set the function trim, to trim this string. Using this query we can calculate the average of all numbers in a column. Let's try to calculate the average for the column price. These parts of query stay the same. We only need to enter the data table name. In this case, it's Excel_DT. And also the column name or column index. In this case, it's price. So the query is ready. Let's implement it in UiPath. I have the table in Excel. This table consists of three columns as mentioned before. I want to calculate the average of the numbers in this column. Let's do it. First, I will copy the path of the Excel file. Add read range activity to read the table from Excel. Add the path here. Table is in sheet 1. Remove the range to read the entire sheet. Create a variable for the table. It's of type data table. Create another variable for the output. It should be of type decimal, if I want to get the numbers from Excel as decimal, but I can also use integer or double. In my case, I will use decimal type. Add assign activity to write the link query. I will write the query as I showed it to you. Add write line activity to print the output into console. Let's run the code to check the result. As you can see, we have this number. It's the average of the numbers in the column price. Let's now move to the last part of this video. In this part, I want to show you how to use the average function with group function. It means I want to calculate only specific values from a column using criteria from another column. Let's explain it using an example. I have the same table again. As you see, the second column contains two different values, food and drinking. First, I want to group the rows using the category column. Using group function, I will get the following two values. After grouping the values, I want to calculate the average of column price for each category. This means, I first read the food values and calculate the average. Then I will read the drinking values and calculate the average. At the end, I want to get this table as output, which contains two columns, category and average. In the category column, I should have the two categories. And in the average column, I should have the average for all numbers of each category. As you see, the first table is called Excel_DT. It's my input table. And the second table is called out_DT. It's the output table, which I want to get as result from the link query. Let's first see how to build a query to get this output table. The query consists of six parts. The first and last parts are brackets. Within these brackets, we set the statements to calculate the data. The first statement is from. Here we set a variable for the rows of the data table, for example row. After this variable, we set the preposition in, and then the name of the data table. In our example, it's Excel_DT. Using this statement, we go through all rows of this table. It's like for each row loop. The next statement is group. Here we want to group the rows using a column. For this, we first set the variable, which we defined before. We write after that, by. Then we define a new variable to group the data. After that, we set the column name, how the rows should be grouped. In out example, we can set here the column category. Here we can also set the column index instead of the column name. After that, we save the grouped rows into a new variable. If you want to learn more about the group function in LINQ, you can watch the group function video on my channel. I explained it in detail there. Let's move on to the next statement. It's let statement. Using this statement, we can save data into a new variable. Its function is like an assign activity in UiPath. So we define first a variable, for example, C, then we use the group variable, which we defined in the previous statement. Then we set the function average. After the function, we write the same query, as we did in the last two parts of the video. The column name in this statement should be price, because we want to get the average of the numbers from this column. The last statement is select. Using this statement, we define what we want to get as output. In this example, we want to save the data into a new data table. So we write the name of the table first, then the functions, rows and add. Using these functions, we add new rows into this table. Then we define the content of the table, what we want to have in this table. So we have two columns. This means we need two variables. The first one is the variable A. This gives us the category. In our example, we will get the categories food and drinking. The second one is the variable Z. This contains the average of all prices per category. At the end, after the brackets, we set the function copy to data table. This function converts the output type into data table. The query is now ready. Let's try it in UiPath Studio. I have here the activity read range to read the table from Excel. First, I will add build data table activity to create the output table, which I want to have as output from the link query. I will create the output variable here. It's of type data table. Let's now add the columns, which I want to have in this table. The first column is category. It's of type string. The second one is average. It's of type decimal, because I want to get the sum in decimal type. So this table should be filled in using the link query, which I will write in a moment. Now I add assign activity to write the query. I will write exact the same query, what I showed you before. Now add write range activity to write the table in Excel. I will write the table in the same Excel file. The table should be entered in sheet 2. Check the option add headers to write the column headers in Excel. I will run the code now to check the result. Let's open Excel to check the result. As you see, we have a new sheet. In this sheet, we have the table. It's filled in as explained. We have the both columns, which I created in the activity build data table. We have only two categories and the average for each category. That's all about the average function in link queries. I hope you enjoyed the video and could learn something new and interesting. If you like my videos, please like and subscribe to help me reaching more audience. If you want to learn more about LINQ, you can check the LINQ playlist on my channel. There are also other interesting videos about some functions. Have a nice day and stay safe. Bye bye.